Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, I have spoken both for and against using RAW files because it all depends on your needs, amount of free time, and skill level. In the hands of a photo artist, a RAW file is typically much better. In the hands of a novice, RAW files can lead to disaster. In many, if not most situations, JPEG is probably all you need. A problem with a typical JPEG is that it is a general average of many tastes and scenarios. The camera doesn't know what you consider important. It's like an automatic gearbox in a car, nice for driving around, but quite a burden in deep snow or when you need to move at racing speeds. JPEGs are great for casual photography, but may fall short of your expectations when contrast is extreme or a specific mood is required. Therefore, they need to be modified. My message today is that JPEG images that come out of your camera are not the end of the road. They are not so hard-baked that nothing can be done to improve them. You can create amazing photographs using just the JPEGs. However, even when a JPEG is very good, it is rarely 100% of what you need. Here are some of the manipulations I typically perform on my JPEG files. The settings I'm listing are for GIMP, but if you don't use GIMP, the logic still applies. First, I check if auto white balance improves the image. I've produced videos on this topic before, please find the links below. In some situations, this can do wonders. You can do this by going to Colors, Auto, White Balance. Try it, you might be surprised. Then I check to see if my photo might look better in black and white. Go to Image, Mode, Grayscale for that. If it looks better in black and white, I will also play with sharpness settings to improve it further. About 5% of my photos look better in black and white. For photos that don't look better in black and white, I correct the color. Most often, I either increase or decrease the saturation. Yes, I often decrease saturation too. I might slide the hue slider left and right to see what effect that has. But most importantly, I correct the individual color channels. All these options are located under the Colors menu. I almost always modify the tonal curve by going to Colors and then Curves. I've made a separate video on that. The link is in the text box. Most often, I don't like how JPEGs tend to blow out highlights. You cannot recover them the way you can with RAW files, but if you lower only the right side of the tonal curve, you can seemingly improve things. If you want to rescue some of the shadows, note that with JPEGs, you cannot go very far. Lift the curve in the shadows region. For many photos, the goal is to make the tonal curve flatter to give the appearance of better dynamic range. JPEGs eat away at your dynamic range a bit. If your photo is too dark or too light, I almost never simply change the brightness, as this can quickly ruin the photo. Instead, lift or lower the middle part of the tonal curve. Grab the line exactly in the middle and move it up or down. This method retains the contrast of your photo much better. You may want to increase or decrease the contrast under the Colors menu. Many of my photos need a tiny push in one direction or the other. Then I fix the slanted lines and lens aberrations. GIMP is very good at that, and below you'll find my tutorials on how this is done. It's an essential step. Although when shooting JPEG, the camera solves some of the lens distortion problems for you, it cannot do it all. It will not make the walls of a building upright, so please check out my tutorial. For me, there is nothing worse than a sunset photo with a horizon that is even slightly off. So making the horizon perfectly level is a must-do for me. Many photographers aren't that picky in this area. Next, I crop my photo. Many photos need a crop to improve composition. I crop over 50% of my photos, easily. Often, it's just a small adjustment to follow the rule of thirds or the rule of fifths, or to eliminate distractions that have nothing to do with the main message I'm trying to convey. I always sharpen my photos, all of them, but I do it in a very subtle way, just enough to give them that fresh look. My GIMP sharpening tutorial is linked below for you. I normally resave the JPEG using the original quality setting, or I choose a quality setting of 96. As I show in my JPEG resaving video, JPEGs can be resaved more times than most people suspect for this lossy file format, without negative consequences. So I do a fair amount of JPEG editing in GIMP. Many of my adjustments are automatic and very quick, and most of the corrections are very small. When modifying JPEGs, you need to be subtle. You don't have too much headroom, but you'll have enough to make it worth your while. Don't discard JPEGs, they're very useful. Thank you very much for watching and possibly subscribing to my channel and leaving a like. I hope you found my video useful. If you have questions, please do not hesitate to contact me in the comments. See you again soon. Goodbye.